This is the second part of the series, and in this tutorial, we are going to turn this vintage woven fabric texture into a seamless pattern. We are continuing from where we left. We've already opened the vintage fabric texture in Photoshop, and our document size is 800 pixels by 800 pixels. For those of you who recently bumped into this tutorial, you might want to take a look at the first part in order to understand how we ended up with this texture. So, how do we create a repeating seamless pattern out of this woven fabric texture? Actually, it's quite easy. But first, let's make the rulers visible. Go to View, select Rulers, and set the ruler units to pixels by right-clicking on the ruler. Now, we will try to fix the horizontal and vertical repeating edges of this texture by using the offset filter. We go to Filter, scroll down the other, and select Offset. Make sure Wrap Around is selected. We will start by fixing the horizontal edge first. If we enter 400 pixels to the horizontal offset, the artwork will slide to the right 400 pixels. Since our artwork is 800 pixels in width, that means that the repeating edge will be in the center of the artwork. And if we enter 0 pixels to the vertical offset, the artwork will not slide to the bottom. It will just stay put. Now, select the clone stamp tool and set the diameter to 70 pixels and the hardness to 40%. The very first thing that we need to do is select the source area to clone from. When you hold down the Alt key, the mouse cursor will change into a bullseye target icon. This area will be our source to clone from. Hold down the Alt key and press the left mouse button to define the source area and move over to the horizontal repeating edge, which is at the 400 pixel, and start cloning. We will do the same for the vertical repeat. This time, we will enter 0 pixel to horizontal offset and 400 pixels to the vertical offset. And again, our artwork is 800 pixels in height, so the repeating vertical edge will be visible in the center of the artwork. You might want to play around back and forth with the clone stamp tool's diameter and hardness levels to make the repeat transitions better. Now that we have done with fixing the repeating edges, in order to make this texture a seamless pattern, we have to control the repeating edges on a larger canvas to make sure that there are no repeat flaws. We can define this texture as a pattern in Photoshop. Go to Edit, Define Pattern, Rename Draft. In our case, the smallest repeat of this specific pattern is 800 pixels by 800 pixels. If we create a blank document, 1600 by 1600, and we apply this pattern to the new document, the draft pattern will replicate itself both in horizontal and vertical direction twice. We will be able to see how the repeating edges merge together and look like when the pattern we recently named Draft becomes an element of a larger pattern. Go to File, New, 1600 by 1600 white background. Select the Paint Bucket tool, change the foreground to pattern, and select the draft pattern. Apply it to the blank document.